My name is Moritz Gerstung. I'm a research group leader at EMBL-EBI in cancer data science. My role in the PanCancer project was co-leading a working group that studied the timing of alterations. And what we found was that many of the mutations we see in cancer genomes occur several years, and in some cases even decades prior to diagnosis. We also found that there are some mutations which can occur even in the womb. And that is, of course, a very surprising finding because it raises the question, what happens in the meantime and what are the additional steps required to transform these into a cancer? And lastly, we were able to work out the ordering of mutations that we observe in cancer, which are the changes that initiate that progression and which are the ultimate steps that seemingly then transform or conclude the transformation that leads to cancer. In order to find out when certain alterations in cancer genomes occur, we exploit the fact that some mutations occur as part of our normal aging process. And those mutations we can simply count, similar to the rings of a tree. And by identifying those mutations that precede in alterations we're interested in and those who succeed it, we can find out in almost chronological time when the alteration has occurred. The molecular clock is a set of mutational processes that occur as part of our normal aging. And that needs to be distinguished from other sources of mutations which do not occur in reflection to time, such as the mutations introduced by sunbathing or tobacco smoking. Once we have identified those mutations which occur as part of the molecular clock, we can use them to time variants that we are interested in. For example, whole genome duplications can be identified by counting those molecular clock mutations that preceded the doubling and those who have occurred after the doubling. The observation that it typically takes several years or a decade to grow a cancer opens a window of opportunity for early detection. And the timelines that we construct, the typical ordering of alterations, provides a yardstick we can use to measure the timing of an individual sample, how far that specific tumor has already progressed on its journey from normal to cancer. While we have learned many things about the timing of mutations in cancer progression, we know relatively little how a tumor grows in a spatial dimension. And this is an area that my group is now actively exploring.